Chef Anthony Sedlak's a busy guy. He has a TV show on the Food Network called The Main. He just opened a Vancouver restaurant called the Corner Suite Bistro, and he comes to Toronto once a year to judge a chili cook-off. When he was here this year, we invited him to come down to the Post to give us some tips on how to make a good chili.
It's one of these recipes that you see so many variations about it. You know, the second you're talking chili, there's immediately a fork in the road, and that's whether you want to do sort of a traditional style chili, which is cubed beef, or even a chili verde, which is cubed pork, or you do the sort of Tex-Mex American take on chili, which is with ground meats. You see some pretty left field ingredients. So, I mean, my chili has cocoa powder, a little bit of chocolate, balsamic reduction. Cocoa powder and chocolate work really well, as does beer and whiskey or bourbon. All those ingredients work well with the stoutness and the meatiness of a great bowl of chili. So first and foremost, whether you're making outside of a vegetarian chili, and there's nothing wrong with vegetarian chili, but outside of that, if you're doing a meat chili, whether it's beef or pork or turkey, you really want to brown the meat. That's when you develop that depth of flavor and the meatiness that we associate with like a really hearty sort of stew-like bowl of chili. You have to have cumin. That's the sort of quintessential spice we associate with chili. A general savory base, onions. Some people put a little celery or carrot. Definitely some garlic in there. When you're cooking chili, I really recommend long, low, slow. You want to cook it at a low temperature, slowly 3-4 hours to really develop that sort of slow cooked flavor. Another great tip I like to encourage people to do, make your batch in like an oven proof pot. Cook it in the oven because you have heat surrounding the pot from all different angles as opposed to that one heat source on the bottom, and that creates again that slow cooked flavor. If you really want to up the ante, you can put it on the barbecue, lid off, and cook it with a smoke pouch. So that's, you know, any sort of hard wood chips that you would smoke, any other cut of meat on the barbecue.
Right.
And the smoke will circulate over the pot and you'll get like a wicked smoked flavor into your chili.